Hey everyone! Today, I have something kind of interesting. Just like in the West, you have Kickstarter, China has its own domestic crowdfunding platforms. A lot of the time, they have products that never really made their way to the overseas market. As you know, I work with Creality, a local Shenzhen 3D printer company. They just did a crowdfunding campaign for the CR-100, a 3D printer for kids that was originally only planned for release in China. But I just checked and it looks like it's for sale on GearBest. I'm not quite sure if it's suitable for the overseas market or not, but let's unbox it and have a look. So here is a USB stick and the CR-100 guidebook. I think that's it. Look, this is so cute. It's a miniature print bed. And the CR-100 is pretty light. So, first thing is I think it's a little too close in appearance to a certain kid's toy. A 3D printer shaped like a truck? Maybe asking for trouble, but it's all assembled. Let me plug it in, level the bed, and load some filament. So on the top, there is a tiny display, small display. It says no SD card right now. And then the start and pause button, home, auto home, hit it. You can press the up arrow to heat up and press the down arrow to cool it. But as I can see, the bed is fixed, so no need to level the bed. And there are some magnets at the bottom, so you just pop this print bed in and wait till you heat it up and print something. So first, I'm going to load the filament. So, in the back. Right, and then I'm going to insert the SD card. OK, Okay, it shows that the printer is ready. So the nozzle is heating up. And when I double press that, I just saw it turn to 0 degrees at 180. Okay. It's going up. I just need to wait for it. So clean lines, no major issues. I think that it is printing at 0.1, and the result comes from a little cheap printer like this. I think it's quite good. I didn't really take this printer very seriously when I asked Creality for a review unit. It's only $20 or $30 less than Enderfree. But without a heated print bed and a much smaller print bed, how could that make any sense? I kind of just expected it to be a curiosity, just like a weird little thing. But it's kind of growing on me. Here's why. Classrooms. The problem with doing a 3D printing class is if you only have one large printer, the kids do their CAD design and don't get to see the results until the next class. The single 3D printer has to print everybody's work. So usually it's at least a week before they get something back, which sort of defeats the purpose of 3D printing. The way it speeds up the design cycle, it also takes all the fun out of it. But if you have a two-period class and each student has their own printer, they can do their CAD design in the first period and print it in the second period, and actually have something to take home at the end of class. Not a huge print, of course. But definitely a name tag or a hair clip or something. I think that immediate feedback makes a huge difference for kids. Of course, not all schools have the budget for one printer per student in a STEM class, but some do, so it's worth considering. But why not the Enderfree? I love the Enderfree, of course, but it's got wires to catch on things, a much more exposed hot end, and moving bed, much more complicated menus, and it requires menu bed leveling. The CR-100 has no exposed wires, doesn't require bed leveling, you just put a card in and hit start. There is no power supply brick, it's built into the base. It's also small enough you can have each student slide it out from a tool crib and bring it into their desk, or even slide one out to bring home for a weekend. Is it perfect? No. This enclosure is completely ridiculous. I would like to see something with a built-in handle as well. I think most of you considering a 3D printer for home are much better off with an Enderfree, but 3D printers in schools have been a problem for ages. Most just gather dust because one teacher gets trained how to use it, the teacher changes school, or the printer breaks and no one knows how to fix it. I think the CR-100 or something like it, it's an interesting potential solution. A bunch of small, very basic, very cheap printers that don't require calibration and don't have much to go wrong. I'm going to take a better look at it. If you agree and see some potential in this printer, and would like Creality to make some changes, leave your ideas in the comment section. That's it for today. Remember, if you can sponsor me, that's great. Every penny helps. But if you can, I still love that you take the time to watch my videos. I'm a pretty ordinary girl from a working class background here in China. I never thought I would have one of the largest YouTube technology channels in the whole country. And I'm very grateful to all of you for making that happen. So even if you can only subscribe, it's a huge help and I really do appreciate it. Until next time, Remember, if I can do it, anyone can do it.